Hi again, this is Carter for OpenSpace. I want to show you now how to go from the default when we launch that comes up with Earth. And I want to just move out as far as humanity's ever been to the moon. So we'll do that now. What I'm going to do is to press the F2 key. That brings up our simple menus over here. And what I have is the object list. But most importantly, I think up here is this focus selection. And what that means is this is our target. Currently, we're at Earth, and we have some buttons up here, Earth, Mars, and the Moon. But truthfully, if you use this drop-down menu, you'll see that any of the objects in here that are loaded into OpenSpace, you can make the center of interest. So what I'm going to do is just come up here, and by hitting the moon button, that's going to move me over to see the moon. I'm going to use the J key to bring my orbits back. So we see the orbit lines. Oh, and now I'm centered on the moon, and I'm going to, when I start to move with my left mouse button, I'm moving around the moon, and that's so even though the Earth is close, my focus is far away at the moon. So to get closer to the moon, I will grab my right mouse button, depress it, and push the mouse away from me. And that means I'm approaching the moon. And here we go. The date counter I have is for the 8th of December. And now I want to get rid of the orbit lines. I hit the H key. That will get rid of them. And now we're looking at the moon. This is an image of the moon from NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. And so we get a global mosaic of the moon down to 100 meters. This is being served by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory Moon Trek. And this is a service that's provided by NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory. You can look up Moon Trek or Mars Trek or Vesta Trek as these are different maps of the solar system that are made available to explore by a website, if you just search for Mars Trek. But also, it enables us to tap into that data stream that we use for OpenSpace, in particular for the moon. So here we have the moon. I'm moving around it. We approached from the Earth, so this looks like the moon that we're used to seeing. Maybe it looks a little dark. So what we want to do is come in and maybe alter the settings for this layer. So I'm going to open up solar system, and I'm going to open up planets. And underneath the planets, there's Earth. And when I open up Earth, I finally see moon. And I open up moon, and there's moon and moon trail. I'm going to open up moon again and go into renderable globe. And that brings up my layers. I open up the layers. There's height layers and color layers. I'm going to open up that. And what we have are several things. There's Clementine, Kaguya, which is from Japan, and their Kaguya mission to the moon, and the WAC from Utah. What does that mean? WAC stands for Wide Angle Camera from Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. And it's being served from our OpenSpace server at the University of Utah's Scientific Computing and Imaging Institute. And so I have done that, and I'm opening up now settings. And with settings, I have the gamma control. And what I'm going to do is lighten up the moon so I can make the moon maybe look a little lighter. I can also use a multiplier, which is a layer below that, and just hit it a little bit. And then maybe I can drag the gamma. I can play with gamma and the multiplier to really kind of make the moon kind of look like, you know, we see it in the sky. You play with brightness and contrast in this way. Now, looking at this data set, we can also move around. We can move around to the far side. And when we do, we see things like Mare Orientale, the Eastern Sea. This is a feature that we can only see on the very edge of the moon. Before we got to the moon and took pictures orbiting it. And so we could kind of see that it was this strange edge-on impact basin. We now know of Mare Orientale as perhaps the youngest large impact feature on the moon. It's a multiple ring impact basin. Right now, I'm not seeing it with great resolution, so what I'm going to do is come down here and just enhance my level of detail. At the bottom of the moon's renderable globe category, I will see level of detail. It's set at 10. I'm going to drag it across, and now I'm seeing this at much higher resolution. So I want to come in close, and so here's Mare Orientale. Nice thing about Mare Orientale, you can see all these radial craters as well, because this really got a hit and all is sprayed out. But remember I told you that we see this feature on the edge of the moon. So if I come in close and I want to pan over to see the horizon from here, once again I control the panning of the camera by depressing the control key, and now I'm going to grab with my left mouse button and I'm going to bring the edge of the moon over like so. So now we can sort of see the edge of the moon, and I'm going to get lower and lower on Mare Orientale. And once again, I need to readjust to come over and look at that. As I get closer to this feature, which from Earth that we see on the edge of the moon, it stands to reason that if we were there, we would see the Earth close to the horizon. And so in this case, we can reconstruct what the Apollo astronauts had seen. And I'll show you one more little trick, especially when you look at this from such a perspective. And we're also reading the height map, thanks to Moon Trek, so that's what's causing the terrain forms that we see. We see the mountains of the moon. I'm going to start to move, and if you press the F key, stands for friction. So the F key, it's a toggle. So like if I hit it again, it will stop, so just before Earth sets. Now let me come a little closer. When I did that, we kind of lost the Earth. So now I'm gonna just rotate. I'm grabbing the moon. I'm rotating around using the left mouse. Let me come a little closer, because what I want to show you are the mountains of the moon that we see cruising by, because they are all bumping up. There's no scale exaggeration here. This is 1:1. So this is what the true height of the landscape is on the moon. And then we see Earth rise. So now, say I want to target the Earth again. I'm out here at the moon. What I do is just come up to, once again, under focus selection, I'm targeting the Earth. I depress the Earth key, and it moves the Earth right to the center. Now, this means I'm going to be rotating around the Earth. As soon as I just grab the left mouse button, I'm going to be orbiting around the Earth. So the moon's going to quickly move out of the way, I think. There it goes. And what I can now do is I'm moving around Earth at a distance, and with the right mouse, once again, I can come all the way back down to Earth. So in this way, we can move about, we can adjust the layers, and so on, to whatever degree looks good, perhaps on your planetarium display or your home display, or wherever you might be using OpenSpace. Thanks.